Westside Gov family. Feel good tonight, man. I'm here, man. I came a long way for this. Street entertainment, man. FNIC. What up? Black royalty, man. Death Valley, man. Come on, man. Nah, I mean, it's all, yeah. I'm on some 08 shit, man. This, I feel good right here. Calico in 110, 100 rounds in it, rose gold jewels on, selling cracks every minute, big niggas out, screaming out, 2 for 15, fish scales on a beam, better dope than Grand Street, watch the niggas lean, got burn clean bigs for 32 on the scene, machine out the beam, flavor mockers is on, 400 for the jeans, my man got shot next to me.
Heard that shit steam.
Motherfuckers.
On that 08 shit when it was 05.
When it was 05.
That shit came out
05. Come on, man.
My bad. It was fire.
welcome to another edition of the Slide Through Podcast. This is officially the first podcast episode of 2020. Yes. Last week we was talking to you at New Year's Eve, so now it's officially the first episode of 2020. Mm-hmm. Big things are happening. We got big things coming up, major investments, updates, all that.
Drafting
is going down. Shit's ending real soon. We ending the shit in a bang, if you know what I mean.
A big bang.
Crazy bang.
$1 trillion worth of bangs.
Mm-hmm. $1 trillion worth of bangs. And we're going to start this bang off with a couple guests. Go introduce yourself.
Pause.
This is a bang. Episode is a bang.
Just cut him off. Cut him off, June.
Episode's a
bang. Cut him off, June.
Relax. Episode's a bang.
Episode's a bang. All
right. Mm-hmm. You guys want to introduce yourselves, though?
I'm David, nephew to Uncle June, right over there.
Okay, June's the uncle. Okay.
I'm Henry. I'm David's friend.
Okay. June's not your uncle.
June's not my uncle.
No.
Welcome, man. Welcome.
Thanks.
Welcome, guys.
And thank you for fixing everything.
Yeah, no problem. Y'all,
you're welcome, man. Back
there. Tech support, geek squad.
You guys are welcome.
Yeah, helping us with our technical difficulties we've been having lately.
For real. Motherfuckers can't
professional
hear me last
production
part.
Yeah, no. Value now.
Yeah. So we like to apologize for the couple slip-ups we've been having a couple weeks, you know. But it's all part of the progress.
Yeah,
2020,
yeah,
all
yeah.
Part of the progress. That's how we do it.
How's everybody's first week of 2020?
It's been good. It's been all right. I'm not going to lie. 2020 is going to be starting off slow for me.
He said, I'm still in 2019,
bro. Are you still writing 19 on papers, like as far as the dates? You know, you're so used to writing the year. And
but
then,
do you guys even write, like, dates anymore?
Yeah.
Sometimes.
Barely.
Yeah,
I don't do it too
I'm
often,
at work
man.
And shit.
Yeah.
I fucked up the other night.
he turned an application.
Put 19, they were like, what the fuck?
Put November.
Are you a time traveler? Like,
you want us to hire you? You still in last year, bro? Hell nah, bro. How was everybody's recovery after New Year's Day?
It was cool.
No recovery.
What was funny is that we were all having breakfast, right? And then we started listening to the episode, and the episode watch, we're going to be listening to this all hungover. Facts. Ronnie was fucked up listening to it.
Yeah. I just got one question. For Miggi, since he was kind of talking shit last year.
He was mad.
Did you get your New Year's kiss?
No.
Nah, man. Stayed in bed. Okay, you know, I realized the kiss isn't that bad, but you know what's even cornier? It's fucking proposing on New Year's Eve. That shit's fucking corny. Okay.
Let me find out you about to do that 2 years from now.
That shit's fucking corny.
Next year.
Watch, bro. You're going to end up doing that. That's what Eric did.
I'll make sure not to.
That's what Eric did.
Nah.
Nigga disappeared.
Makes sense.
I was gone, though. It was a little too crowded.
Yeah, well, what you guys
uncomfortable.
What you guys do?
There was like 4 of us here. What are you talking about?
What you mean? When y'all were in the crowd? Like, bro, there was like a line of empty space.
Oh, no, bro.
Just a straight line of empty space? Like,
you were standing there.
What did you guys do for the count out?
Spray champagne?
Yell.
Yeah.
Spray champagne?
Yeah, niggas were yelling on their fucking phone, just
For like a good 15 seconds.
Yeah. I would say 30
seconds for the IG video on the story.
I'm done. I just took
it. What'd you do, Miggy?
He's hella dabbed.
Stayed in bed, bro. I fell asleep.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What y'all do? What y'all do?
Hella devs.
Hella devs. I feel it.
Stayed in bed playing games online with the boys.
There you go. Okay.
Every second it hit 12, I was like, Happy New Year, guys. Happy Put New down Year. My phone.
Shit, I just grubbed at home, bro. Rolled a blunt, that's it. And after that, shit. Now you got me off a blunt, so I'm like, shit, I'm good with that. I just threw it in the pack, so I was like, fuck it, why not? Started off good.
Starting off with a liftoff.
Man, goddamn.
Shit.
Throw away the pack, the cigarette pack?
The fucking backwood pack, man.
I had to, man.
Fuck that. If not, I was going to be like, shit.
He's like, I could have took
it. We got a backwood smoker over here. He's like, you threw it away.
He said, that shit's 10 bucks now, bro.
He's like, the whole
thing. I like he made it seem like it's cigarettes, and yeah, man, I had to put it down. Yeah, you know what I mean? My wife, my kids, you know what I mean? Started to notice, man. They started to notice something different in me. Yeah, I feel it.
Oh, shit.
Well, shit didn't. The celebration didn't last too long because by the second day, World War III started trending. Shit started trending, and people were like, what the fuck? And, you know, the memes came out, and now articles are coming out.
Trump was like, you know what? Fuck it. He saw all the memes on Twitter and shit. He's like, you know what? Fuck it. I'm gonna do it for the people.
He's like, fuck it. He's like, fuck it. Might be my last year. Fuck it.
Yeah, fuck it.
He wanted to leave with a bang for sure.
He said, I ain't gonna have to clean this shit up. He said, I'm gone.
Nope. Yeah. Probably wants to make Mexico pay for it too.
All of World War III.
The whole World War just funded by Mexico.
We're gonna go to war, and Mexicans are gonna pay for it.
Yeah,
tremendous.
Mexico's actually like, hey, bro, cheeklets. Thanks for this wall, because now we can keep motherfuckers out. Between this war.
Yeah.
See, I'm thinking that he's just thinking to himself like, okay, I only got a year left. These people are impeaching me. If I start a war, I could have 3 or 4 more years. Like, that's what I'm thinking. He's probably thinking another world war. Fuck it. FDR was in hella terms.
What's crazy is just still how some Republicans can still defend him till this day. It's like, dude, he's starting a fucking war. You're still defending him? Can't do no wrong.
They better be lining up for them fucking drives,
bro. I was weak about that one dude that broke it down on social media.
What?
They're like, so what's happening with this war thing? I don't get it. It's like, basically, he killed the big homie, so everybody mad. So now they're going to come through and kill what is supposedly our big homie.
Oh, yeah, they put some money on his head.
They put 80 million.
Is that real? Is that real?
I don't know if it's real or not.
I saw it once. I tried to do some research, but nothing will come up on that.
I feel like if you're going to put money on his head, it's going to be more than 80 million.
You got to look at the dark web.
What did George Lopez say? I'll do it for half, motherfucker.
There you go.
George Lopez.
Hey, Secret Service actually looking into that shit, too.
They don't play with threats to the fucking president, bro.
Oh, yeah.
They don't play that shit.
You can't even,
I don't even think I doubt he's staying in the White House just because they assume that's probably one of the places that.
I heard he never stayed in the White House, really.
For real?
Yeah, he was always in New York.
Nuh-uh.
Yeah.
That big ass house, bro. I'd be up in that motherfucker, bro.
The only time he was in there.
I think it's how Dave Chappelle put it. Like, why would anyone want to stay in that Scooby Doo ass house?
I mean,
for real,
bro. For the mystery, fuck it, bro. Yeah,
hey, come on, look at Barack. He threw a barbecue on that motherfucker.
Yeah, that's true.
Everyone was like, or he also put it like, Barack was the first person to be like, this place pretty nice.
Yeah, let me put a swing on this shit. I'm gonna have a barbecue. Invite everybody.
You see that front lawn, bro?
Yeah.
Perfect spot for a barbecue.
Perfect spot for a concert, bro. Yeah. Cookout, everything.
Motherfucking cookout, invite everybody in. Everyone get a plate. Feel me?
Fuck.
Hey, he would have made hella money. $5 a plate.
You could fund a whole presidential campaign on that.
Hey, probably come get some barbecue, some good fucking
on Pennsylvania Avenue.
You feel me? Fucking Michelle Obama's mac and cheese. What?
She put her elbow in it,
bro. Shit, shit sounds like a good time. Shit. Way better than the whole fucking little McDonald's, Wendy's fest that Don Trump threw in there.
He didn't even have In-N-Out.
Well, for the second time, he got Chick-fil-A at least.
Oh, yeah, they got Chick-fil-A in there, huh?
They still fucked up. He did it a second
He's
time.
He's just doing fast food, though. Like,
Oh, man.
Fucking asshole, bro.
He's supposed to be celebrating like a big win.
He's a fucking asshole.
Fuck that.
That shit was funny. Little kids, bro. Got him happy meals and shit.
Hell yeah.
But I guess in all seriousness, man, prayers for the troops that are heading out there and that are there. Recently, we just heard, well, I just heard that there's already an attack.
Yeah, supposedly there's an attack today in Iraq bases, U.S. bases in Iraq.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
It's not looking so good.
Is it like any deaths?
No, they haven't said yet.
Just happened.
They're probably just fighting right now. They're probably just going at it.
That's fucking crazy, bro, to think about that. And we're just here talking.
I know, bro. For reals.
That's some shit.
That's why. Iran said get all the troops out there, bro. You feel me?
Iran said get all the troops out if you guys want to de-escalate the situation. But the U.S. didn't want to do it.
Because, of course, bro, they don't. I mean, U.S. don't back down, bro. They don't back down.
I think the way me and my dad talked about it, because my dad's a captain in the army.
Oh, shit.
We said that they sent 500 that were in Kuwait over to the base or the embassy that was attacked, and then overhead they flew in 750 troops.
Dang.
And they're sending more.
Yeah.
That's a lot of niggas.
For real, bro.
For real. Damn.
Yeah.
That's a lot of us. Like, imagine us going there.
Yeah. Where are we dropping, boys?
There's our age and younger going into a motherfucker.
Jumping off of helicopters.
Hell yeah.
Tell you, I can't even do that.
You can't even buy cigarettes or alcohol, bro.
Yeah, I seen like a meme where like, a guy, you know what I mean, he kills somebody, there's like a thumbs up, but then like he tries to buy cigarettes, it's like, no. He can't do that.
Cigarette commercials. I'm gonna need more than that.
Yeah, for real, Well, fuck me. I hope this doesn't escalate. I hope it dies down.
But it just started. It escalated with the attack.
It's about to escalate, bro.
Yeah. Well, I'm just hoping for the best.
For real.
Hoping for the best. I guess that's all we got.
So, what would you guys do if war was brought here to the United States?
Weather control. Straight up.
What you mean?
They could do it too.
Just put some tornadoes on a nigga. Like,
put some tornadoes
Harry Potter spells.
Just plug it in.
Hey, it's been a known fact, bro. They got the technology to do that type of shit.
Yeah, it's fucking spooky how much money we got in our military budget, nigga. That shit's crazy.
And they just spent trillions and trillions of fucking dollars on I don't know what. Who knows what? How many nukes? How many bombs? How many?
Definitely some fuck shit.
Yeah.
Damn. Y'all seen that?
All right, so what are you guys gonna do if it starts?
Oh, I mean, what can we do?
Shit, board up the house, bro. Get some straps.
Just be part of the chaos, I guess.
Part of the chaos.
Just protect the block, man.
Start the purge.
For real.
Protect my block, nigga.
I mean, bro, if shit hits the fan, bro. People gonna be looting. Like, people just gonna try to get the fuck up out of here. Just.
Yeah. And you know what? And like, even some of our jobs would be like, "Hey, you still coming in though?"
For real, bro.
You still coming in though, right? Yeah. Like, man, I'm getting shot at, fam.
I know, bro.
There's a tank.
It's like, have you gone outside, bro?
The tank outside, bro. And my shit's a roundabout.
There's tanks, tanks all over Kennedy Row and
you
shit.
You get Uber a tank.
Uber. I know, right? The Uber helicopter, bro.
That's what they do in New York.
Yeah, they got that shit.
Skip all over that shit.
Yeah, but how much you think that shit is?
It's cheaper like than a fucking car ride, apparently, since you sit in traffic longer than you would going on a flight.
That's true, too.
That's some shit.
Yeah.
They're playing the system, man.
Motherfuckers going to New York just to be in a helicopter ride?
Just to be able to Uber it?
Yeah. But where do you land?
On top of buildings.
Probably like top of like hotel.
Intersection.
That's why the traffic's so bad.
I work at McDonald's, right?
Yeah. No, you're Ubering it to a fucking pizza place or some shit.
Right. Yeah. Just one block away.
Y'all just get some Uber Eats from a helicopter.
Pulling it next to your window.
He throws it at you. He just drops it. Parachute.
Yeah, that's funny. That's funny.
Well, anyways, I seen a video before. Wars does start, they said that the first things that they do is turn off water and electricity and stuff like that. So as soon as it starts, they say it'd be smart to fill up your tub with water and just pretty much keep as much resources as you can. Now, I'm ready for doomsday, bro.
Got the generator.
Got the generator, got everything.
Got the bunker tub full.
Yeah. Because that's the first thing that will go as soon as war hits. Shutting off the water and electricity.
I don't even got a tub,
you
bro.
You haven't taken a bath full? He's had a tub
full of fucking fresh water. Bath water is the drinking water.
Shit. Come home one day, your little brother swimming in it.
Sariki, come on in.
It's cool, though. It's cool. If Bear Grylls drink the water out of fucking elephant shit, bro, you can drink that. It's fine.
Bro, my cousins
did he actually do that?
Yeah.
No shit.
Survival, bro.
My cousins were in Salvador. Last time my cousins were in Salvador, fucking there's like a whale, and I guess that's where they got the water from. This nigga jumped in.
How the fuck he get out?
No, like it wasn't a whale, but it was like it looked like a whale, but it was blocked off or anything. Like, so it was just filled with water. They,
oh, fuck. It was the water that like people bro? Got in. No, nigga.
It was the water that people would use.
So it wasn't a whale.
No, but it was a well, but then they like blocked it off. They filled it all up.
And then that's how the ring started, bro.
El Salvador.
They threw the bitch in and they just filled it up and just filled it back up with water so motherfucker could use it. But he was while swimming in it and shit.
What?
It was all hot because to him it was hot as shit. So he was just chilling in it. And these motherfuckers are like
a hot tub?
Yeah, and these motherfuckers that like own that shit, they're like, oh, we use that.
We use this girl.
He's like, oh shit. Damn. I'm gonna stay in it for another 20 minutes.
I would have been hella mad.
I would have pissed as fuck.
You ever just gotta run a fade?
For real, bro. Fuck.
Oh shit.
Well, I guess to end this thing, I mean, everybody says how The Simpsons kind of predict everything, right?
Yeah.
There's that one episode where it showed him on his deathbed.
They
put $80 million, I guess, supposedly on his head. I mean, you think he's gonna die?
You think?
Nah, sometimes.
If he dies,
eventually he will die.
With the war end,
he's gonna die, man.
I think. I don't know.
He might not die as a president, but he might die after he's not the president.
Yeah, that's real.
Like, actually, they still got the bounty going and shit?
Yeah, they probably will.
For sure they will, you know?
Yeah. It's going to be some John Wick shit, bro. They're going to smack him. No, for real. They're going to smack him.
I don't know. I forgot who it was that said it, but there was like, our problem isn't with, like, the American people. It's with the American leaders.
That's what the parliament said. The Iranian parliament.
Yeah.
And, like, two other motherfuckers, right? So
pretty much anybody that's in control right now, that's what it's against.
Yeah.
You know, so think about it. They go out of power, so but whoever comes up, they're not going to be beefing with them. It's, like, with them.
Just give me a million for each head, bro. I'll try. All I can do is try.
A million?
But how would that come about? Yeah. Like, let's say you do snipe Trump or whatever, and then how would you, like, all right, now how do I get this money?
You gotta take his head.
He said, bring you gotta go back to bring the head, hand, bro.
You gotta bring the head.
Go over there.
That's hard.
Cut his head off.
Two guys come up to you, put a bag over your head. Don't tell nobody nothing.
Yeah, that seems impossible.
No, bro, you just gotta snap.
Nothing's impossible.
You gotta snap yourself, like, which Trump, you know, which Trump.
Hey, I just shot Trump. Hey.
Send it to the homie, you know that you got him on snap.
Like a fishing trophy? Like, hold the ring him up.
Yeah. Fucking take it to UPS.
You just take a toupee.
Yeah. And then you're gonna get your fucking Bitcoins.
Hey, that's true. Yeah,
that would probably be the only way they'd get to pay you on that shit, to be honest.
Hey, yeah.
Yeah.
You got Bitcoin now? Nah? Well, fuck you then. Thank you.
You got Venmo? Yeah, got Cash App? Got Zelle?
I got Venmo. Venmo it.
Just Venmo that shit through.
I'll shoot it to your OnlyFans. It's cool.
Oh, fuck. Well, that's about does it. We took it serious.
Now, last question.
Trump is worth
80? If you guys were called into war, it's kind of like you have to go, right? It's not if you want.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure they'll send like bounty hunters after you. Yeah.
Damn.
If you don't want to go.
So what's the rule? What's the rule? Is it if you're the firstborn, you're male firstborn, you don't have to go, right?
Yeah, but I also heard if you're flat-footed, you're not qualified.
No, I'm serious.
I'm safe.
DJ's just like, bro, I'm good.
No, I'm safe too.
Miggy's not safe.
I think I don't know about my feet.
I just tell them I'm flat footed.
Hey, they open the door, I'm in a wheelchair. You seen that?
You pull up like this.
What's up? Would you? Oh, for reals? Oh, I would have.
So I got shot.
Trust me, I would have.
Send me, I'm ready. Send me, I'm ready.
Well, back in the day, people used to say that was gay, right? Like,
it was gay.
Yeah.
And be like,
people
oh, no,
used
can't
to cut
I'm
off
gay.
Their finger, their trigger finger.
That's how you prove it, I guess, bro.
You slap him?
No, you just go like that, bro.
He's got to answer the door like that?
I'm flicking a wrist, bro.
I'll fuck you. Holy shit.
They're like, never mind.
Nah, but yeah, people used to cut off their trigger finger so they wouldn't have to go to war.
Oh,
that's some Assassin's Creed type shit.
But you gotta learn how to shoot with the middle finger.
I would
then,
do that if it was like about going to Vietnam or some shit where it's just like hella out the way. I'm not trying to go there.
So Iran is good. Iraq is good. Iraq, I wouldn't go.
I mean, they got.
You said Vietnam.
Yeah, Vietnam.
I wouldn't go to Vietnam. I'll go to Iran.
I mean, Vietnam just seems like just a worse area in general. Like, that shit's got, it's just swampy, like, hot as fuck. Like
shit, man. That's a beautiful
I don't
want to
be in a swamp,
Did you see Forrest Gump, bro?
Yeah, fuck that.
Yeah.
Nigga didn't see shit but some tracers. Like, I don't want to be there.
Somebody's going to come back as a Lieutenant Dan. No, Lieutenant Dan.
Until they come to the door.
Well, there's hella videos like where they knock at the door and then the dude opens, and once he finds out he's getting drafted for, he starts acting out retarded and drooling. And they're like, no, that doesn't matter. He's like, you qualify.
You still qualify.
Oh, yeah, I've seen that from Long Beach.
Yeah. He was like, man, nah, we got people with no arms. Man, we got people with no legs. We got people with no arms and no legs. Like, nah, you definitely qualify. Damn. Like, there's no escape from it.
If we get like hella good prosthetics and like robot arms for people and shit, no one's gonna be able to dodge that shit. Like, they'll just be like, don't worry.
We already got robot arms.
I think all the trannies.
We legit got robot arms already.
But I think all the trannies should be drafted first. And then,
okay, DJ, you got to explain.
If you got the we appreciate everybody's gender. Just a disclaimer. We love everybody. So, we love people.
Hey, man, let DJ explain.
If you got the balls.
So explain it one more time,
please. Oh, just stop.
DJ, explain.
Explain why.
Because.
Just because.
Nah, I'm just saying, like, if you got the balls to like change all that crazy shit from your body, and you could go through all that crazy sex change and. Think about it. You already went through some crazy shit just to do that change. So why not, you feel me,
because
go to war?
Technically,
and
they don't have the balls no more.
I was about to say, like, why don't they send, like, the
what
like,
if it's
rapists,
the opposite?
The child molesters or, like, the murderers out there? Yeah.
You're going to talk about war? Last year, I was a man.
Yeah, I ain't trying to see Bruce Jenner saying that Uncle Sam wants you.
I'm just saying.
It says under so do I.
Very small letters.
I know.
Fine print,
yeah.
That's your exam right there. Print.
Miggy's not liking that look.
I'm just thinking about it. I'm just like, fuck, I gotta go.
No, I feel you though. I feel you.
He feels you, see?
Yeah.
You ain't alone here.
Yeah.
So, is that what you think? Like, that's what you believe? Well, yeah.
Or
some prisoners that did hella like.
Bad shit.
Yeah, shot motherfuckers up. Like, you know what I mean?
Killers or. You know.
Well, so yeah.
You really didn't even go kill
and they can minimize their time if they come back home safely after the war.
I don't think so. I think they sent them out there to just pretty much die, bro. But they said if you're a felon, you can't get drafted, right?
You can't. Because they're not going to give you a gun.
But you're not.
Yeah, but you're not in the U.S.
You ever see Suicide Squad?
Like,
why don't we just do that?
Pretty much.
Back in the days, wouldn't they offer like dudes prison or join the military?
I know they do that with firefighters.
Oh yeah,
when there's big fires, they send them out.
They did that with the last
big one.
But I'm saying like if like a person was like getting into like legal trouble.
Uh-huh.
I think that's when they were younger. Yeah.
That's why. Yeah.
Either you go to boot camp or you go to prison.
Or you could go to the military.
That was back in the day.
Supposedly.
Yeah. Now they're making too much
according
money
to
you.
The source of Blood In, Blood Out, yeah.
The homie Miklo told you?
Oh, I forgot about that. Yeah.
Well, that's what came to mind when you said it.
Oh, yeah.
Remember, they both got caught. Yeah, one of them chose military. One of them went straight to jail.
And then he became a detective and shit. Yeah.
If you guys got drafted and you didn't want to go, what would you guys do? Would you guys go or you guys, like, face the consequences?
Just tell them I'm gay.
Not going.
I gotta go to Mexico. They're like, we got the captain's gay already, too, so you gotta go.
So you don't want me. I'm in the podcast. Y'all don't want me. Tell everybody what y'all do, man.
Who's gonna report it, y'all? See? Who's gonna be the one reporting it?
Who's gonna be podding about it, bro?
Who's gonna be podcasting about it? Yeah, talking
be
shit
the
about
one,
it?
The reporter on the enemy lines.
Damn.
I don't know. I could probably say I'm already in. I think I could pass.
Pass one.
The op switch side.
If I get drafted, I'm good, man. I'll fit right in, bro. I'll just throw in a little.
Yeah, what a little thing where they wear.
Habab or Jabab, some shit like that.
So you'll go? You'll be like, fuck it, I'll go?
No, I wouldn't go.
No?
No, I wouldn't go. Fuck that.
You think if, like, you'll fuck around and, like, just act like you got Tourette's? That'll, like,
What the fuck? What would Tourette's? He's gonna be yelling anyways, bro, so it works out fine.
Just startles the hell out of his fucking squad. He's like, oh, fuck! And everyone's like, oh, shit!
The only reason I would go would be for the training.
For the training?
For the training.
No, they're not going to train you. They're just going to throw you in there.
Right.
Do you know how to shoot? All right.
See, but like,
they're just going to take you to the shooting range, bro.
I mean, I do got a good shot. I mean.
All right. They heard you here first.
You heard him here first. Nah, fuck that.
All I'm saying is that bitches in the Middle East are pretty bad. Like,
he's not lying.
He's not lying. Like, I could shoot up her husband and just get with her.
You couldn't find a single one? You gonna shoot her husband?
Damn, man. That's cold as fuck.
Hey, man, if she's bad, bro, it's worth it. Hey, man, I'm with Eric.
Damn, bro, you finna leave with her ankles out? Like, yeah, that's mine right there. You see these ankles?
Oh, no, if a girl got sexy ankles, it's a wrap, bro. You
see these ankles on her? Well, should we move on from this?
Well, Australia's burning.
Yeah, man.
Oh, yeah,
Australia's burning. Rest in peace of Trump.
Oh, shit.
That's
early.
1 month
oh,
after
my
Australia.
Bad.
Yeah, you heard it first.
Does anybody know how they started? Or just like any other big ass fire, nobody really knows.
No,
just someone starts it pretty much.
Yeah.
Nobody really
bullshit.
Knows. Something, man.
Rihanna, devastating.
How about you give some millions away?
Hey, y'all heard about that that nude model?
Yeah, shout out to her.
For real. See? She got, I don't know how much. How much?
Oh, fuck.
She raised half a mil.
Yeah.
Half a mil.
Yeah.
For that
someone
shit.
Thotting for good, finally, bro.
For real, bro. For real. That's an Instagram model I support.
They deleted her shit.
If I was single, I probably would have bought some nudes.
I mean, she was already a nude model, so what's her name? Because we can Google her shit and find
it. I forgot.
I want to find
it. Good idea.
But they deleted her.
Put on screen. Put
her
on screen.
IG. So they're like,
her fans only still up, nigga.
Yeah,
that's all you need.
I don't know what her name is, bro.
I don't know, but I'm pretty sure if you search it up,
yeah,
you can find it.
And all there's celebrities hitting her up and everything now. Drake's in the DMs and shit. You know that's the first motherfucker in the DM.
That's laughs as fuck.
Hey, girl.
Imagine Drake just hits
appreciate
the,
what you're doing.
The gift like this. It's his own gift like this, bro.
There probably is, bro.
He's like, you don't have to do this.
Her name is Kaylen
that's
Ward.
Her?
Kaylen what?
Kaylen Ward.
Damn, she's bad as fuck.
Yeah, she's bad, bro.
700,000 is what she raised.
Damn. She a Barbie.
What a queen.
Straight.
What a queen.
I salute her for doing that.
God bless your breath.
She deserves
heart.
Like a she deserves like a prize, like a Nobel Prize.
Yeah, Nobel Peace Prize, honestly. For
real.
For real, bro. She deserves like a medal.
For real.
Yeah.
I mean, they do the Pornhub Awards too, right?
She could enjoy it. And I'm pretty sure they're gonna hit her up, bro.
They hit up Iggy Azalea. She turned down the
Man, she's stupid, bro. You know how much money she could have made?
Well, we have the casting couch here, so I mean.
You just got to sanitize that motherfucker.
You just got to baby wipe that motherfucker.
Just burn that whole fucking couch.
Get a new one.
Spray a little Febreze.
It's good, it's good.
It's cool.
Febreze and some clone.
Some cologne.
Oh, that's nasty.
But yeah, damn, bro, man. Salute to her. She raised hella money. She could have done hella shit with that money, but she
a lot of horny motherfuckers,
bro.
For real. It's for the cause.
And they're
man.
$10, bro.
All for a good cause.
To be honest, all the nudes she sold, all those niggas is whacking off to that shit, bro.
Right now.
They could probably put out the fire with all the skeet that like came out of that shit, bro.
Definitely. Definitely. Collect the ski donation.
You know, helicopters just fly over with the bucket of water.
Yeah. It's all slimy, just slowly coming out.
Slowly. Like just doesn't put out like half the fire area they expected. It just comes out hella
the helicopter
late.
Got to wiggle a little bit. Got to do a spin real quick to get all out.
Fuck around those random kids.
Oh fuck!
Random kids everywhere. Years later.
Oh shit!
All mixed breeds.
Oh shit!
Half human, half kangaroos. But nah, Bong. See me. We keep joking around.
I know, bro. All right, come on, let's get serious.
Keep joking around. Prayers, Australia, man.
A lot of animals have been burning, man. It's fucking sad.
Koalas,
bro. This is sad.
And koalas are already extinct, technically.
Yeah, I know. There was a dude that had his car full of koalas.
We gotta save the koalas.
Bruh, the kangaroos, bruh.
Everybody else is just straight
burnt on a fence.
That was
seeing that shit was kind of fucked up.
For real, bro. That shit is just, man.
What? I don't know, man. I don't even
know what's crazy? Talk about animals. Rabbits have been put in the endangered species list.
Species? Are they really?
Yeah.
No way.
Swear to God.
What is there a specific type of rabbit?
It might be specific, but I mean just rabbits.
Are there different types of rabbits?
Yeah, there's jackrabbits.
Oh, Bugs Bunny?
That's Bugs Bunny. He's a jackrabbit. There's the something tail rabbit.
Okay, I didn't know there was different. Because I was about to say, I see a bunch of rabbits all the time.
I guess it's a specific rabbit.
They reproduce like crazy.
Yeah, bro. Yeah. PetSmart has them all the time.
Well, they can't get rid of them, bro.
I don't know. One of them,
they fuck crazy, bro.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. Like, why would that be a thing? If there's a literal phrase like they fuck like rabbits.
Yeah. Bro. And have you seen rabbits fuck? Yeah. It's crazy, bro.
They're legit the energizer bunny, bro.
Like,
honestly, RIP to the.
He said it so serious.
Every because
that's
night.
I don't get it. Like
I haven't seen rabbits as fuck.
Oh,
I have.
I mean, yeah.
I've heard of the term, like, fucking, like, rabbits. Yeah. I just haven't seen rabbits fuck. Like, that's just not something I choose to do with my free time.
I was a kid, bro.
He's a fucking Playboy, but Playboy child. Let me watch the History Channel.
I typed it in wrong, bro.
Whoa. Lights flickering.
World War III.
Are we still good?
And the taker comes. Are we still recording?
Yep.
All right, for sure.
No, Ricky, I typed it in wrong, bro. So it took me to that.
National Geographic.
Yeah. I mean, the riverine rabbit in South Africa, but that's it, bro.
Still in danger, bro. It's a rabbit.
They're still in danger.
But yeah, Puerto Rico also got hit with a big ass earthquake and a tsunami warning.
Yeah,
prayers to Puerto Rico, man. They've been going through it. Couple years ago, they had like a tsunami or something.
6 point last year.
June still got to go over there and drop some kids off, bro.
I know, right?
I think it happened on the south part of the island. We're going to be in the north.
He said, we good. He said, my bitches are good.
We good.
When did this hit? Oh, 12:24
6.4. Fuck.
That shit's wild.
Mm-hmm. Badass earthquake.
We had some earthquakes here in all across the coast too recently.
But I don't be feeling shit when we got earthquakes.
Huh? Yeah, no.
I'd be too high or just, I don't know what. I don't feel shit, right?
And then go in your timeline. Did you guys feel that? Did you guys feel that?
Yeah, it's like, what the fuck?
I thought that was my stomach.
Like, yo, man, I thought I was going in.
Earthquakes here.
I thought that was me. I thought that was all me.
Like cheese, lactose.
Prayers to Puerto Rico and in Australia. Yeah, man. Hope everyone's being safe out there.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Thank you that donation to what was her name?
Snow
Bunny.
Snow Bunny. Yeah.
Taylor Ward.
Taylor Ward.
Kaylen Ward.
Okay.
Kaylen, this episode is dedicated to you, Kaylen Ward. Thank you. Thank you for you.
I knew what Kaylen was.
Here's some shit that
you don't know more.
I don't know. I think about sometimes, like,
Kaylen, do you think that,
like, all this shit happened? Like, we've had years before shit started off, but like, we've had three like crazy ass shit happen in fucking week one of 2020. Oh, you guys think it's like just because we got hella information coming at us at once, like 24-hour news cycle type shit online, or you think it's because like shit's actually just...
I think it plays a part of it. Think about it. So many events could have been going on, but without the social media we have now, nobody would know. And what is it? Someone predicted that this century is supposed to be... end. Yeah, it's supposed to be the end of the world, or when Jesus is supposed to come back and rescue us or something like that.
The apocalypse?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That'd be some crazy shit.
I thought that was like when 2012 hit, like everyone
died. I think that was an earthquake.
You think Jesus will take a nap? 2012,
they said the world was going to end. Yeah, yeah. 2006, because the omen came out, they was like, oh, fuck, the world's going to end. Remember 1999, well, 2000, the world was supposed to end.
Yeah, with the computers and shit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. The Y2K.
Well, shit. Well, I guess this is the new one.
I mean, I don't think they were wrong. I think we just predicted it way too early.
I don't know. I mean, like, some lady, some prophet, I guess she predicted the assassination of JFK like 7 years earlier. Mm-hmm. And now she predicted that 2020 would be the end of the world or some shit like that.
Okay, but you don't believe The Simpsons.
Come on, man.
I'm just throwing little things out there, man.
I feel you.
Also, biblically, they also predicted that they're going to come by with fire, because mm-hmm. how God ended the world with water, how he flooded earth. So now this time he's coming back with fire, and, you know, Australia's on fire right now, so...
California's been on fire.
It's about to start getting on fire.
Yeah. These nuclear shits will fucking put you on fire ASAP, bro.
For real.
Yeah.
Iran's probably going to end up on fire.
Iran, yep.
I think it's more of a... touching on that subject, it's more of a money thing. There's money to be made on war, so.
Oh yeah, definitely.
So there's people in
Doesn't
there.
Doesn't the gas prices go up when the war starts?
Everything goes up.
It puts America a lot more in debt. That's for sure.
Yeah.
I mean, they just spend trillions of dollars, is what Trump says proudly.
But think about it. Little do we know that Trump owns the place where they bought all the guns from, or where they manufacture all the guns. Oh, little do we know he just paid himself $3 trillion. For the United States Army, but in reality, he owns it. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, like you never
That's
know.
What it's always about, though.
I could see him I could see him doing that scam, bro.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, he took money from a little cancer charity thing, children charity thing. Yeah.
I mean, they've always been trying to run scams like that. Like, that's kind of what shit ended up just coming down to, basically.
Well, that's what the war in Iraq started with Bush.
Yeah.
A lot of people know their family owned a lot of oil rigs in the United States. And when it started affecting them, that's why they went to war over there. There's pictures of Bush and Saddam Hussein, like, together, like, hugging.
Yeah, they funded the war.
And then it's like, there's the conspiracy that it was... an inside job, the 9/11. So.
Well, it was definitely preventable. That's for sure.
Bro, they had box cutters. The fuck?
My bad, bro.
Yeah, but they also. but they also didn't think they were gonna fucking fly the plane into a fucking building, bro. Like.
I know, but I don't know if I'm a pilot and somebody comes at me with a box cutter. I don't know.
They probably just thought, all right, look, they're just gonna.
Take the plane.
Yeah, you know what I mean? It's fine.
Just clock.
I'm like, all right, yeah, all right. Kick the motherfucking hand, bro.
Yeah, they probably thought it was like some ransom shit.
Yeah.
They probably didn't think niggas were just going to fly.
I'm sure they have procedures
like,
for
who
that.
Who flies a plane into a building, nigga? Real like, shit. Nobody does that.
Fucking suicide, what was it called? Those guys?
Suicide bombers.
Shit.
Shit, bro.
Probably some shit went way left. Who knows? Maybe it was supposed to start off something small, like a robbery or something, and it just...
Let's just crash this plane.
Yeah. You know, we're going to go to jail for life. Let's just die.
Yeah, or something just got way left out of control, and who knows.
Oh, they swerved left, bro.
Yeah. They swerved. Definitely swerve.
Fucking starting off 2020 with a bang, talking about 9/11 on podcast.
That being the typical podcast. 9/11, what did you think?
Where were you on 9/11?
Where were you at? Do you have something to do with it? Cool.
I was sick at home.
People was crying.
I thought I was going to go home. I even asked. I was like, so are we going home? Like, no, we're staying here with each other. I'm like, oh, I won't be with you.
I was on the floor.
You were on the floor?
Yeah.
You felt the...
I was like 2 years old.
What were you doing?
I was like... probably sitting. Like, I don't know.
Playing Legos.
Yeah.
Some shit.
All right, so prayers to everybody in the world, man. If it's the end of the world, man, are you guys content with your lives?
Got no choice.
I had fun.
And I'm saying, are you content with your life this far?
Yeah.
Yeah?
I made it this far.
All right, bet.
Yeah. Motherfuckers don't make it this far. A lot of motherfuckers.
Yeah. That's 27.
Gotta look at it positively. Mm-hmm. With the world ending somehow, still gotta look at it positively.
Just like the world of Fallout.
Mm-hmm. Shit. I don't know. All you can really do is just be yourself. You can just do you. That's all you really got. So.
Do you end the war?
Yeah. Do you fuck with the war?
Do you fuck with the war?
All right, man. So moving on. Who's Aaron Hernandez?
He was here last week. You remember him?
Yeah, you remember?
Can you pull up the picture?
Aaron Hernandez, former
Patriots player.
Patriots.
I thought his last name was Roger. No, he's not. That's for the
Packers. It's a different Aaron. They're making a Netflix doc or something, like a series or something.
He killed somebody. About,
yeah, he was a gang member and a football player.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
A gay game.
But is it just going to be interviews, or is somebody who's going to be portraying him?
I'm not sure. There was a trailer, but I didn't see anyone acting as him. I think it's kind of like a doc, because they're not using actors, I think.
Okay.
So they're just talking about like how his life came up and how he grew up and then where his career went left and where his mind was at and how they were trying to help him out. But
what did he do?
He got arrested for murder.
Killed his best friend.
Yeah.
Supposedly he killed his future brother-in-law. It was about to be his brother-in-law.
Fuck.
So yeah, and then he had a gay lover in prison, and he left him like a no. And
did he have a gay lover? Or he was just getting shit pushed in, and he got used to it.
I mean, what's the difference, man?
When you die, there's consent. There's consent. And there's force. That's the difference.
I like you, and I want you.
Yeah, exactly.
Some booty.
Yeah, well, I don't know.
Some say he killed himself because if he would have got convicted, his family wouldn't get any of his money.
Mm. Oh, really?
Oh, yeah.
That's true. I remember. Okay.
Yeah, that's.
So he killed himself?
Yeah,
he killed himself. So he's no longer alive.
In prison.
Nope. He's no longer alive.
R.I.P.
Yeah.
I mean, what do you guys think of that move, though?
Hey, you think his homie's still locked up?
I don't know.
Wait, what do you mean move?
I mean, about what June just said, that he committed suicide because if he would have got convicted of the murders that...
I would have done it. I could do that.
You could kill yourself?
To get the money to your family, though, bro.
2020 is going to be the year.
He's just like, oh, yeah.
No, just look at the context. Look at the context. Either you die and your family starves, or you could leave them well off. Like back in the day, I used to think, bro, I'm going to be the biggest.
It's crazy how
you
just automatically,
I mean, what you got to think about, it's like you're going to leave people broke, and you're going to be in jail for the rest of your life. Or you could leave them well off, and that's you die with a peace of mind. Mm-hmm. You know, well, that's the way I look at it. That's what I'm like. They're like, hell yeah, I'd do anything for my family. So it's like, I wouldn't, fuck it. Anyways,
so
I thought about this before.
So you're hanging on a cliff, and they're holding you. And they
start
had one hand.
Right now.
One hand was $1 million. The other hand was you. They can only put one book, one hand. You want them to pull the $1 million up or you?
A million is a million. People can make a million. I'm sure you left more than a million.
No, but let's say the world ended and y'all survived, and
So the world ended, then the currency don't worth shit.
Terrible hypothetical, bro.
Now y'all think about it too.
So what were you saying?
Anyway, when I was younger, I was thinking of being the biggest mobster ever. And I was like, fuck it. Now listen. And I was like, okay, well, I'm about to hustle my ass off.
And go to jail?
I'm going
to
get all this money. And if I get caught, like, at least my family be well off. You know, like I thought about it before. It's like I could do all this illegal shit, and if I get caught, at least my family will be well off. So if I'm locked up, at least they're taken care of, and that's what matters.
Yeah, and that's kind of like the motto with like Chapo and Escobar when you see them in those.
That was me when I was like 14, series. 15 years old thinking.
Watch Ricky, you find Ricky in the backyard, 13, 14, burying his money.
Should I hella bold?
$8? I know.
$8?
I'm trying to grow a tree.
Taking his lunch, sitting down on the bucket upside down.
Nah, but yeah, I would. I don't know about y'all. I would.
Yeah,
I don't know. Yeah, put in that scenario. Yeah,
that's just a scary situation, man.
Yeah,
Miggi wouldn't. You could tell.
That's just a whole different weird situation.
You say, DJ, bro, you can be broke, bro. I'm staying in these bars with my lover. Yeah.
And they also did mention about his concussion and his head injuries, about how that probably came to play and how he was thinking, because later on in his career, he would go psycho and shit. He would go crazy.
CTE.
Yeah. CTE.
So look at Chris Benoit, bro.
Yeah.
For real. R.I.P.
R.I.P. because his family, bro.
I was like, that's a good touch.
Yeah. I mean, killed his family than himself. I mean, I don't know.
Hey, man.
It's just all crazy.
He was a different guy in the ring.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Just the same as Aaron was a different guy in the field. Yeah. A lot of people loved him. I mean, it's just weird because then they show the part where they interview the teammates, too. And then the teammates just look uncomfortable as fuck because I don't think they really knew him like that.
He touched your booty in the shower.
Snap ass.
Good game. Oh, you know that scary movie? When they're going to the
slap ass. Team, bro.
Like that Keanu Peele slap ass?
Slap yeah. ass.
Slap ass. No more. The fucking player comes back. It's like a new player. He comes. He's hella thick. Serious, you know, man. He's like super tempted. Fuck. But yeah, well, are you guys interested in this? You guys think you're gonna watch it?
I don't even know the guy, so probably not.
But you could get to know him.
I'm
the
gonna watch reach it. I'm into like murder docs and shit like that.
Yeah, summer one.
Teach you how to get away with shit.
I want to know why he murdered his homie.
Yeah, I'm enough to kick it with you.
Remember, they were saying he was gang related too. Yeah. They were saying he was part of a blood gang apparently, or something like that.
So okay, but why he killed like his?
Yeah,
sisters,
that I don't know.
That's what I want to know.
Yeah.
Well, you can find out if you tune in to.
Oh yeah, that's what I meant.
But then on top of that, but then he's dead, so they can't really explain too much.
Man.
He's not here to explain the whole story. I think they're only going to put information that they think they know about.
So he had a lover in jail.
Yeah.
Is that dude still alive?
Why are you obsessed with the lover in jail?
It's crazy, man.
You got his number, though?
No, is he still locked up? Hey, they can get questions about him. They can interview him, bro.
I think I'm going to commit a crime.
They can interview him, nigga. That's what I'm just saying. Like, what if they interviewed him?
What are you asking? Did it feel good when he pushed the shit in?
Nah, they're probably going to
ask. It says right here that.
Silly. Silly Ricky.
That he murdered him because I guess he knew about his gay tendencies and he didn't want it to get out.
So you got gay on him,
so. Wait, he killed his gay mate?
No, his friend.
Wasn't he drunk or wasn't he on some shit too?
Just CTE. just fucked up in the head.
Like, you know I'm gay.
Wasn't that what that soccer player? He sent like someone to kill that what do you call it? Transgender?
Transgender? Yeah.
Transgressions.
The T word.
Did you assume my gender?
No.
So I'm back.
But yeah.
But yeah, shit. Shout out to him.
What?
He's dead, bro.
Yeah, none of these topics have ended in the right.
Yeah, none of the topics ended right.
Bro, hey, we can't take none of this shit serious, bro.
I mean, they say 2020 is off to a rough start, bro. Yeah. So, you know, I guess.
I mean, you got to make light of every
situation. It's a good
situation.
Start.
Yeah.
I like to start.
Can't be
so
all
hard.
Sad, bro.
I know.
Yeah.
I mean,
Yeah. Well, moving on to another situation. I got a battle coming up next month, February 22nd, on a Saturday.
Huh? You guys should have done it on the leap day, on the 29th.
I don't know what day it is. So.
You a battle rapper?
Yeah, well, yeah, kind of. Well, this is going to be my last battle.
Mm. Oh. So he's an upcoming retired battle rapper.
Upcoming retired.
Yeah.
What are you going to do for retirement, bro?
Oh,
go to Florida.
Trying to celebrate.
Trying to celebrate.
Trying to celebrate afterwards.
Because you know you're gonna win, huh?
Maybe. I think it's a judge battle. So
bro, I'm trying
so
to
there's...
give you that confidence, right? Yeah. Get that confidence, nigga.
You know, you
be
know
like
me.
Bart, nigga. I'm gonna murder that motherfucker.
You know me. You know me. I'm gonna take the money.
I know.
I'm gonna take the money.
I'm gonna be there hoping nobody pulls on your shit, bro.
Oh yeah, please, yeah, please, please. I'm gonna have my fly ass fit on.
I know,
so please,
bro.
Please.
Hell yeah.
Can you wear my gear?
But yeah, February 22nd, come through.
Can you wear my Instagram on your jacket?
Gotta pay me for that. Gotta need a bag for that. But
yo, who took that picture?
I got
dude?
You with 20 trash bags.
Remember that picture they took of you when the food was pulling on your fucking shirt?
Yeah, and but that's the culture though. That's the culture. That's how you know you're
that's how you know it's real.
You're killing it.
That's
yeah,
how
man.
Killing?
Yeah.
Can't
yeah.
they just be like, yeah? Oh.
That was back then, but now
they gotta
yeah,
like,
yeah, that's the
legit.
New wave now.
Now you gotta wrinkle the shirt, man.
Yeah.
That's the new shit. Gotta push him, gotta like.
You fucking killed it! Like,
my shirt,
yeah.
bro!
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, bro, I just bought this shit.
For real.
Nah, man, there's been a couple battles where their shirts got ripped.
Yeah, no.
That's too intense right there, man.
Yeah.
You go with something like that, bro, they just rip everything off.
Just start off the battle like that, be like, hey, yo! First things first.
Time.
You got someone giving you water, like.
It's in the Gatorade room. They just squeeze it.
I got a little, how long sweat you been doing
that? I've been doing it since like high school. It's been going on. We started this league called Central Coast Chamber. It was just really out of thin air. It just happened suddenly. And, you know, we threw events. Some were successful, some weren't. But when it was popping, man, it was cool. Everyone had a good time. It caught quite a good buzz. Like, there's battlers from Bay Area, from Southern Cali who came through. People from different states eventually came through. And
New Orleans,
bro. Yeah, New Orleans. Yeah. Well, yeah, well, that was kind of separate from Central Coast Chamber. But, you know, but...
Someone from Texas came in. One
yeah,
time
yeah, I battled the guy from Texas. Shout out to Keegan. He's the one that got me linked up with all my battles. He's the reason why I did those battles out there. I did a battle out there in San Leandro and San Jose. He's a reason why I did that. So now he's throwing his last event on Central Coast Chamber. And, you know, it's only right that you know what I mean. I go in there because I was the first battler to ever battle for the league. Mm. So now it's only right. You know what I mean. I'm in there for the last event.
And you're gonna walk out with the belt.
I'm walking out with some kind of belt.
Yeah. I asked because I think I found you on the internet.
Okay.
And cool. It says you started March 28th, 2012.
2012. Yeah, that was the first event. I battled. And the funny thing, I battled
Kaylen versus Miggi.
Yeah, I battled.
He's reading your blog, bro.
Yeah, I battled.
Nah, there's
Keegan.
This shit called Verse Tracker. And yeah. It shows all of his battles and like a record of it.
No way.
Yeah. Verse Tracker is the tracks all the battlers ever.
You got your resume right there, bro.
Yeah, I got a resume. I got
does
like
it show if you win?
And your last one was Miggi versus Link.
Link, yeah. That was a while ago. That was like 2 years ago. Yeah, man. That guy was dope. It was good.
Shout out to June though, man. I was starting to stay fly.
And starting to stay fly. Shout out to June. It wouldn't happen without June either. Take some credit for that.
Open, man. Yeah. You got to keep it open.
For reals. For reals. So now this one's going to be going down at the J Lounge, formerly known as Planet Gemini. So make sure you guys go there. $20 at the door. It's going to be worth it because there's going to be some big names,
no
big battlers.
No shirt pulling.
Big battlers, you know what I mean? Guys like Danny Myers from South Central LA, guys like A Ward, who, you know what I mean? They're like up there. They're up there. We got, you know what I mean? One of the greatest battlers of all time, in my personal opinion, Thesaurus. He's going to be battling there too. So getting to battle in front of some of the dudes that I grew up watching on the screen. So that's going to be dope.
Oh, yeah.
So just make sure I come out. It's going to be great. Get to watch a whole bunch of battles. And pretty sure there's gonna be a bar, so.
So boom. I think you can smoke weed in there?
I mean, like, we smoked there plenty of times in the back, so I don't see why any different this time.
Fuck it.
Me and DJ gonna be lit.
Yeah. It's gonna be starting pretty early, I think, maybe like 2 or 3.
Damn, 2 or 3. I'm thinking it's gonna start like at 7.
But you know, yeah, battle rap events do start a little later because you know people are coming in from all over, so it takes a little time. But nonetheless, everyone's just vibing before, during, after. Just all a good time.
Is there age limit?
I think it might be. It's 18 or 21. Depends if you're, you know what I mean, if you're gonna be drinking.
No, if it's 18 and over, if you're 21, they'll give you a bracelet.
Yeah. But okay.
If you're 18, you can get in the door. You just need a bracelet if you're gonna.
You're gonna be drinking. Yeah. Yeah, that's about it. See, hope you guys come out.
Slide through, everybody.
For real. Mm-hmm. The podcast gonna be.
We'll have stickers for you guys.
Oh yeah, passing out stickers. Passing out stickers, everyone. What the fuck is this? Oh, and also the day after, I'm going to Murderverse Live Radio. I'm gonna be doing a little podcast session with them. Ooh. And I could bring one person. So.
When?
So you know, you guys play spin the bottle or something.
Yeah, everybody buy a raffle ticket. See, who's
gonna go. Next raffle ticket.
Buy a raffle ticket, man.
Where's this radio station at?
I know they're from Hayward, but they moved their studio. I'm not sure if it's still in Hayward or San Jose. So one of those two locations. They're doing it on Dirtbag Dan's old YouTube channel. And, you know, for those who don't know, Dirtbag Dan, a legendary battler as well. So, yeah, they invited me to come on over. You know, we're trying to set up a day. I was like, hey, you know what? How about the day after my battle? Because I'm already going to be requesting that day off. So, might as well make it a weekend out of it. Mm. So, I'm excited to see the guys, Ryan, Gray Fox, Tantrum. I'm excited to see those guys.
For sure.
So, yeah. Introduce them to, and they know about us too. They like our podcast. Mm.
Shout out.
Yeah, giving us plenty of compliments before. So, They've been wanting to do a crossover, so hopefully we can make that happen this year.
For real.
Yeah.
Sure, we got stickers.
We got stickers now. Hey, I don't know about you, but shit's getting pretty serious, man.
We got stickers now.
Got stickers. Kind of a big deal.
High production value.
Yeah. So let's move on forward.
Charlemagne
the God, you are nasty, man.
For real, bro.
I don't know.
Do you think like he got his shit measured, or that's just like some random thing?
Nah, bro. I think he legit laid naked and he got
measured out and got.
So Charlemagne the God wanted to give a.
But he gave it to our DJ or a different DJ?
A different DJ.
His DJ.
Give it to DJ Envy, his co-host or his co-worker
from the Breakfast Club.
His friend for many years.
What did he give him?
It's a birthday gift.
It's a Christmas gift.
It's a Christmas gift. You guys watch.
Oh, since it's all.
No, I guess it just dropped today.
Yeah.
This your butt cheeks, yo. This a black butt.
So he made a mold out of his own ass.
That's what I think.
My yep.
ass. No, that's what he said.
You can't tear my ass up like that. You be gentle with my ass.
You got his ass molded.
What?
Even his balls.
Tiene loyo?
His balls is on
there? Yeah.
And it's ashy too, bro.
And it's ashy.
Oh yeah, he made him put lotion on it afterwards.
What do you want from me? Use your imagination, young man. All right.
Bam.
I don't know, bro. What the fuck?
Supposed to stand up right by you, and what we can do when people walk in, that can be their own Apollo Law.
Nah, they added the wrinkles on the balls, bro.
Yeah, bro.
It's a mold, bro.
Hey, you know it was cold.
It's a mold, so they're gonna catch it. Yeah, they're gonna get everything.
What you just said? Put your thumb in his butt.
Put your thumb in his butt.
Nah.
Say thank you.
Say thank you.
How about that? Say thank you.
Put
your finger in the butt. Niggas, you need
drawers. Come on, man. This smell like silicone.
I don't know how to feel about this. This is a call for.
Nigga put the finger in the booty. Said, I don't know how to feel like.
Yeah. I don't know, man. I don't know. They got a whole different level of a friendship, man.
Thank you. All
right. Emmy's at home smacking them right now. Smacking them cheeks.
Rub it down. You be gentle with my butt.
So what do they even do with that, bro? Now that it's there, like.
I have no idea. That's up to DJ Envy.
Come on, whoa, there you go.
Well, and you put lotion on it too.
There you go. Lotion that ass. Lotion it for me.
Rub it in. Charlemagne, you're a nasty man.
That's a nasty.
You're
a
nasty.
Not mop. Not mop.
What about a bat, bro? What's up? Oh, no.
Do you guys find this funny? Yes or no?
Yes.
I find it funny. I find it weird.
I find it hella fucking disgusting.
I know.
Shit. I'm probably fucking around and get my shit.
I'm gonna give DJ my ass for Christmas. Like,
for real.
Right? Like,
it's just gonna appear on your y'all niggas' doorstep, nigga. Y'all don't know what it's gonna be.
I didn't order anything.
Open it up.
You guys can guess who?
It's gonna be stamped, Eric.
They branded your ass, bro?
Yeah, bro.
He put some real pubes in there?
For real.
Might as well.
It's a mold
for immersion
to catch everything,
and a blunt's gonna be in the ass. It's an extra little gift.
He said he makes it into a blunt.
He said blow the birthday candle out. Here's your cake.
Fuck, he should have done that and made it as a cake for his birthday. Should have saved it for his birthday.
I know, right?
Hey man,
but how does a cake artist get that, or they just go ahead and go off, like they just freestyle it?
I mean, amen.
Or does Charlemagne's that crazy that he'll be like, nah, I want you to actually look at my ass and balls and get the picture out.
For a real cake?
They could probably take the molding like on there and copy it.
He just sends him a nude.
Probably make it look like it, but not the
he has a nude shape. In his wallet.
Fuck.
What?
I don't know, man.
He's like, what?
It's a whole different type of friendship, man.
Is that where we're trying to head, or we give each other's asses?
I mean, since we didn't get...
If we got enough money to throw a head on a silicone ass cheek, why not? Fuck it. We're going to get there. We're going to get there. Fuck it.
We're going to get there.
What?
Fuck it. What? Yeah, what? If we get there to enough money to where, like, we could just go ahead and waste money on a piece of shit like that.
That's real.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna front. I got a mold in my closet of my own ass.
Do you fuck it?
Nah.
Don't lie.
I just bring it out every first of the month. Smack it.
Smack it.
It's a ritual.
Put it back in the box. And it's...
Hey, you be getting home stupid faded, bro. So I don't know.
Would you show it to like any girls you bring home?
New definition of fucking.
It's my grandma.
It's just my grandma.
Anybody remember grandma?
Yeah, mamá, ¿dónde moviste mis nalgas?
Said, mom, you been moving my ass, mom?
Told you not to touch my shit. Never do nothing.
Can never do nothing.
What's wrong? Oh, no, it's just my mom grabbing my ass again, man.
Not new.
Go, taking it back.
Y'all are sick.
I don't know what Charlemagne was thinking during that whole process. Like, I bet to him, he thought it was funny throughout the whole shit. While
it's funny. Yeah, it's
probably hilarious. Like, while he was laying down there getting it, like, ha, 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 he's gonna love this. It's like, just, what the fuck?
It just seems hella out of pocket. Like, I just don't know. There's no context, nothing. Nigga's just like, hey, here's my ass. Where my balls hanging down.
But then again, that's Charlemagne.
Hope you like the wrinkles.
If you know Charlemagne, I guess that's something Charlemagne would do.
For real.
What do you got to lay on to get a mold out of, like, your ass?
Like a surgical table?
But, like, what do they do? They just, like...
They basically, it's like some shit, I'm assuming. I'm assuming you just like sit in some shit that like
I was thinking
slowly
like a
you
tub.
Like sink into or some shit.
Yeah,
or
maybe, yeah. And they just actually, fill it with something?
No, hold up. They got the wrinkles. That shit was laser scanned.
Oh, you think so? Lasers. Laser technology.
No, yeah, no. They
3D printed.
You can like reconstruct shit with lasers in like computers.
Because isn't that how they make certain sex dolls? Like they get bodies of real like, you know.
Shout
I mean?
Out Russia.
They got the best sex.
Yeah. Yeah, they get bodies of real women with that figure.
I mean, like, the thing is like 3D printing too. They got to a point like you just have like a whole bunch of plastic. They straight up can like laser cut plastic into shit. Like, it's crazy what we can do with lasers now. It's some shit. Like, make ass cheeks out of lasers now, apparently.
Precisely too, cool. Like precisely.
Yeah, precisely.
With the hole.
I feel like
with the hole.
With the hole.
Yeah, with the hole. Dude, yeah. What the fuck?
That's tight.
He said like that's tight.
It just That's tight, bro. That was tight.
That's awesome, bro.
Well, you better make it tight.
That was tight. Hey, you didn't lie.
My shit ain't loose, huh?
I wish I got to pay for a mold of Kim K's ass, bro.
I'm pretty sure they have it, bro.
They have to. You can probably buy that shit.
Yeah.
Oh, Kanye's probably have it.
Think it's on Amazon?
Kanye bought all of them. Kanye. No one's going to have your ass.
Yeah, Kanye just buys out all of them. Yeah. I mean, didn't he like
pulls buy back it? A curtain. I got the full set right here.
The only one he doesn't have is the one that Drake has. Nah,
man. Bought a whole ass mountain. What do you think all that real estate was about, bro? She needs a place to put all those asses.
All those asses. The motherfucker gonna slap Yeezy on it and resell it.
And they're sold for thousands.
The new Yeezy cheeks.
The new Yeezy cheeks.
Oh, man.
Oh, man.
Y'all something else.
Would you buy some Yeezy cheeks?
For the flex.
Shit, bro. I didn't even buy Yeezy sneaks.
Everybody's on their gram, like, yeah, my cheeks came in.
It's like, oh, y'all selling the Yeezy shoes, huh? Hey.
Yeezy cheeks.
Get up in the Yeezy cheeks, man.
Now you have it right next to you on your shoulder. You're just kind of laying on it.
What if he just, like, hella pranked everybody? Everyone thinks they're getting Kim K's ass, but really it's just a mold of his ass.
Just recolored.
Yeah, I think you'll know.
Yeah, he'll notice.
You have to know.
His hairs are even on it.
I'm sure someone is like expecting a fucking big old fucking jello shit, like big old jello ball. But I mean, Kim K's ass.
I mean, is it gonna be 2020 Kim K ass or like a couple years back Kim K ass?
I think they're gonna
around
want
the
to
Ray
notice.
J around the Ray J era.
Hey, man, salute to Ray J. Ray J is a fucking legend. Underrated.
For real. That shit's still up.
For real.
Hell.
For real.
The I hit it first joint.
Yeah, that shit slapped. That shit fucking slapped.
Yeah, that shit was slapping.
Yeah?
On to the next or what? On to the next or you still got more man. Ammo?
I remember motherfuckers had that shit in their PSP.
Yo, I got this dope ass video to show you.
For real.
Don't tell my mom.
They're on field trips watching that shit, bro. That's so funny,
shit. Where were you when that came out?
I was behind the seat, bro.
Nigga was on the boom mic.
I was like three thistles, like, what the fuck?
Holy shit, boys. I was in the back.
I was in the back, like.
It's like, oh shit, my dick
came out. It's like, oh shit, is this double team? No, my mic just fell, sorry.
What the fuck just touched my shoulder, bro?
Oh shit, was that you? Nah, fam.
I thought we were spotted. My bad.
I felt the connection. I don't know.
That was the thing.
She looked at me.
I thought we was trading for a second.
Moving forward, it's done. We good. All right.
Enough about Kim K.
Enough therapy. All right. Yeah. Cool.
Right. Moving on to even some more crazier shit.
I expect this in like Florida and shit, but
was it in Florida?
No, it was in Vegas.
Oh, it was in Vegas.
Vegas would be my second option.
Yeah.
That's what
we're talking about. Vegas had a lot of mobsters back in the day, right? Or like still to this day, I think.
Yeah.
They're basically the ones that built Vegas.
I believe he's an OG mobster, bro.
Through Sinatra?
I believe this old man is an OG mobster that just went to his old ways.
I mean, shit.
Wait, so what are we talking about?
So this guy in Vegas had an issue with his unit. Or whatever,
his manager. Oh well.
No, like in his unit. Yeah, okay. No, but he was the whole thing was like, here's some water damage in his unit or whatever he was living, and he went to go put. I guess he's been putting complaints. I don't know, but he finally got fed up, went down there with the gun, and just shot the manager twice.
I like how you started laughing midway through.
Because it's funny.
Why are you laughing?
Because it's just straight mafia, bro.
Hey, he just got like, done watching just, the Irishman, bro.
He just said, like, straight to the leg, bro. Like, I ain't going to kill you, but I'm going to warn you, buddy. You got to get this shit fixed.
Let's fucking laugh.
Shot him twice?
Shot him twice.
I don't think this is the video.
It's the one below it, I think.
He got inspired by Robert De Niro.
He saw Irishman three times in one day.
Huh.
He was like, I want to be like,
I was watching that yesterday. It's pretty good.
Yeah.
It's pretty good.
But well, yeah.
93 years old, the fact that.
That he could still
bust a fuck, cap?
Yeah.
Oh, look at his shit.
Oh, he's on that shit. God. Oh, my God, man. Yo.
Dang, on Mafia, bro. That's a fucking, that's a fucking crack.
You got the cover for the episode.
This had to, I don't believe this. This had to happen.
DJ, good crack.
Good crack.
Good crack.
Good crack.
Good crack.
This is Mafia right here?
Yeah.
When, on
when
perks,
you get high
on
your own supply
he's
stuff, the Mafia.
Hard.
Holy shit.
He looks yo. Like the Warhead character. You know when you eat the Warheads?
Yes.
Oh, shit.
The Warhead candy, bro. That's what he looks like.
This nigga looks like.
Damn, bro. This nigga took the last heroin of the fucking Civil War and shit.
Nah, bro. This nigga smoked the pookie. Hit the crack pipe and went down and shot the manager up, bro. And was still high off his mind when he was taking this picture. Oh,
fuck. And those complaints he wasn't submitting, bro. He just had him right there on the, by his mailbox.
For real.
Looks like for a real. Star Wars alien.
He was smoking. He was smoking that shit for
he
like
years, bro. Looks like
years,
he's a puppet again. Someone put their hands on him. Yeah, bro.
Ventriloquist up your ass.
How the fuck did he get blood on him though?
They were like,
he shot him down to the floor.
No, they tackled him to the ground.
Oh,
cops
shit.
Came in.
They tackled his ass.
Yeah.
Oh, done.
They treated him like he was young and shit. Back in the good old days.
He's got some goblin ears.
And yeah, to be 93 and to be upright how he was on that shit. He was on that shit that kept him going. That shit.
Really? Because yeah, his eyes tell me otherwise, bro.
He was definitely on something.
Yeah. He was on that shit, bro.
I think he's just shocked that his white privilege didn't work. He's like, what? No way.
Yo, if you stare and don't blink, I swear he's moving closer to you. It's just scary,
yeah,
bro.
You stare at it long enough and then you blink, it pops up in your mind.
Ronnie's gonna have nightmares of this motherfucker just popping up.
Yeah, can we move this away?
The thing is, though, is that his picture looks like just as shocked as you are to see him.
He's like, yeah, I know, me too, right?
Yeah, he's like, yo, this shit freaky, right? Like,
all I did was shoot him in the leg.
Twice.
2020, y'all sensitive.
Y'all sensitive.
Back in my day.
I like how it says allegedly opened fire when we seen him clearly shoot him twice.
Yeah.
I think it's on the CNN one. He was charged with attempted murder, kidnapping, discharging a firearm within a structure, burglary with a firearm, carrying a concealed weapon without a permit.
Kidnapping?
Yeah, because he just pulled it out of his little coat pocket. He shot him once. I think
he's like gotcha, bitch.
You
thought it was a handkerchief, huh?
He shot him like in the stomach or the gut or some shit. And then he kept talking.
That's probably one of the worst places to get shot at.
And he bucked him in the leg.
Yeah, it's dangerous to get shot in the leg. Well, shot in period, but I mean, you got some heavy organs in the leg.
He did some Conway shit. Shot him in the kneecap. Eat that.
He recorded it?
No, this is because there's
Glock.
Cameras in the lobby.
He pulled out a Glock 9mm handgun.
Yeah.
He's like, sit your ass right here, man.
Straight up, he's tired. He's
I keep telling you to stop doing this shit, right? Man.
I kept doing.
You know, I'm tired of you not fixing my motherfucking leak, man. I'm telling you, nigga. It's been the third time. You better sit your ass down before I shoot your ass cut. Boom, he shot his ass.
Right there.
Yeah, that's nuts, man.
Oh, I missed it.
Fuck. Why'd you miss it?
Yeah, fucking
oh, here it is.
Look, walked it all cool.
I mean, like, what else do you expect when an old man comes in? You don't expect this guy that has a gun.
Just pull a Glock
and
out.
He's ready to shoot,
know, right?
And shoot you.
You're all polite. Hi, sir. How can I help you?
Yeah, he was giving him that baby boomer talk.
Yeah.
Hi,
he
sir.
Said, you gotta sit down for this shit, bro.
Look.
He's popping his collar and shit.
He's like, take a seat. Look. Take a seat.
He said, you ain't gonna sit? How about now?
The female caller stated that an elderly male, later identified as Robert Thomas, was armed with a firearm inside the management office and was...
We're making a quick exit. That's when the woman behind the desk asks to leave, and the 93-year-old gunman lets her go.
Sorry, have a good day.
He said, I'm here to kill you, baby.
Have a good day.
He's on here to kill you, baby. Have a good day.
Niggas on a mission.
I'll see you tomorrow, honey.
Do you want a butterscotch?
No.
Range is only a grazing wound. The apartment worker falls to the ground, but the 93.
He said, that ain't shit, bro. Take this. Eat that. Eat that.
The police are approaching the office door.
Shots still being fired.
So when he shot him in the leg, the cops are getting there. The cops got there.
We gotta make entry.
This thing got double chin his foot.
Hey. How you doing in there?
Is shit bulletproof?
Yeah.
Drop it. Take, fuck this nigga, man.
The surveillance camera. You can see.
He said, oh, shit. Oh, dear God.
Oh, bro, if that shit wasn't bulletproof, he would have been dead, bro.
Yeah, what the?
I think it's bulletproof. I think it's going through.
Nigga still.
Why not? I think it was a warning shot. Yeah.
That's just his face when the fuck.
He wasn't going up?
He's like,
oh, this shit just froze like that?
He was still shocked when that gun. He said, they shot at me.
Hey, can you rewind it to where he still where he shoots him? The cop.
Rewind it to where he shoots him.
I don't think the glasses. I think he shot like on the
apartment worker falls to the ground.
Nah, like it grazed him.
Nah.
Gunman isn't done. He shoots again. You can see the muzzle flash. But again, it's only a grazing wound.
He shot him in the ass. Yes. He grazed his ass.
Damn, that's fucked up.
You better go get that's a mold, cuz.
That's just fucked up.
No fuck on my mold. For DJ Envy.
Come on, bro.
Yeah, man. Cop was he came like, through and he fired. He fired. Yeah. He shot through the door.
See, the glass or shattered, but it didn't go through.
Yeah, there's a hole right there. He didn't have to do that, man. The guy put his gun down. He's like, oh.
Look, the shit shattered. It didn't go through, though. Like he didn't have his gun down. Like, oh,
well, now it did, but still, like,
he's like, motherfucker.
He caught him on the way out.
Yo, that fucking mugshot, though, man.
This is funny.
Yeah. Yeah.
I was trying to be the hero.
He's trying to explain himself while the cops arresting him, but the fucking mold. I told him about the mold.
That's crazy. What if it wasn't even mold, bro? What if it was just, like, the blinds?
What if he was just really on shit and he thought that his fucking apartment was going underwater, but he was really on drugs?
I don't know, but I'll tell you what. That motherfucker is going to take all of the complaints seriously now.
Yeah, oh, yeah. For real.
For real, yeah. You got a water issue? Go there right now.
Mm-hmm.
You got a gun? No? All right, cool.
It's like a 93-year-old shot me, bro? Fuck.
For real, bro.
I mean, shit, nigga made change. Made change happen.
There you go. At least it was white on white crime, so you know it's a good thing for that.
Yeah.
Yeah, they had to balance it out. You know, they had to do some shit.
I support that shit.
That's what Florida's for, though.
Yeah,
balance all that shit out.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if you're from Florida.
Yeah, that's why. Moved to Vegas.
Yeah, for real. Crazy, craziness.
He was only living there.
He fired the shot. It went through the glass, but missed.
What?
Told you.
Which missed Thomas, but went through the lapel of his jacket.
Wow.
Wow.
He had an angel, man.
That's why the nigga looks so shit.
He's almost dying.
He's like, whoa, I can never imagine being shot. Shit.
My grandkids won't believe this story.
Homie went in there with his permanent stroke face, bro.
Yo, he's gonna be in court with that same face. The judge is gonna have to.
I was trying to be nice.
I was trying to be nice.
I knew where I was aiming.
I gave him a butterscotch afterwards. You know they carry butterscotch candies on them. They always carry a candy.
Yeah.
Well, fuck.
Oh, shit. NFL?
NFL playoffs.
NFL, man. Niners going all the way.
Still?
Still.
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 Oh, who they got next?
Vikings.
Vikings?
Yeah.
Vikings going to win.
My friend, actually, I got a friend named Nick who's a diehard Seahawks fan.
Mm.
And when he saw the Seahawks versus the Niners,
He was not having a good week.
Nah. Me and June had a great week after that.
You guys want to go celebrate?
Whoa, pause.
No, not like, man, y'all.
No, I'm just saying.
No, I'm talking Ronnie.
Oh. Niners, Seahawks, and Packers. Okay. Yeah. Damn. That looks fire.
I don't know.
You know what I mean? I'm excited to see these teams because finally it's like something new. Like, you got Texans in there. You got Chiefs in there.
I think it'll be Baltimore and the Chiefs.
Ooh. No Niners?
No, to before the Super Bowl.
Nobody picks the Packers, though.
Not yeah, man, I wouldn't be mad at whoever goes in the Super Bowl. Whoever goes in there, you know what I mean? I'm happy. Whether it be Niners, Vikings, Hawks, Packs.
I think Packers are going to...
Packers? You think it's the year of the cheese?
Cheese Packers.
Mm-hmm. The year of the cheese.
The cheese heads.
Yeah. They be rocking the cheese.
I know. Good luck.
Are we going to see a bird Super Bowl? Actually, Ravens.
We could.
It's going to be Seahawks and Vikings.
No, it's going to be the Niners and whoever else.
Whoever else.
Yeah.
Niners and cheese, Niners and Texans, Niners and Ravens.
It's going to be Niners and Baltimore, Titans, bro.
Niners and Baltimore. It's going to be a little repeat.
Mm-hmm.
Get the official game, because last one was kind of like
where's
a little.
Where's the Super Bowl being held at?
Miami.
Miami?
Yep.
Miami?
In the Dolphin Stadium?
Yeah.
Damn, hella players are going to be off cocaine. Hella players are going to be off
cocaine. The Dolphins coach is still there?
Yeah.
See, we could have been this.
Could have been this. He recorded himself doing hella blow and shit.
Yeah, what
he
the
sent
fuck?
It to like some prostitute or a stripper.
Something.
Yeah.
Bro, you gotta be so dumb, bro.
He probably thought that was his ride or die, though, bro.
He was the regular. I'm thinking of you while I'm doing this.
Yeah.
That's just like, weird, yeah.
Doing a line and shit.
Well, he probably did hella coke off her tits and ass, though. You ever thought about that, maybe?
Yeah. Probably pulled the wolf of Wall Street before.
Yeah. Body shots.
Blowing in the booty.
Baby powder. That's fucked up.
Like, he only does it off of a mold of her.
Because the mold won't fart back, bro.
For real. Fuck around, get the coke everywhere.
Yeah.
No, fuck around, shoot that shit back in your throat, bro. Oh my God. Sit in there. Hell nah.
Bro, that'd be funny, like.
Yeah, Ronnie, I wonder what you experienced.
Bro, like, what if you're, like, legit gifted a mold?
It depends on whose ass, though.
Yeah.
No, even though, I mean.
You were legit considering it, though, like.
Yeah, because then. But then I'm
so,
like, yo,
wait. So say.
It's a chick.
Say like an ex.
Nah, bro.
Just add an order, sent you a mold of her ass.
I mean, take it back, bro.
How are you gonna take it? You're gonna go jump it out there.
The thing, like, I was like, at first I was like, yo, it's cool, like, if I got an ass, but then I was like, nah, man.
You're not gonna use it one time before you send it?
Nah.
Don't lie.
Bro,
give it to her back used.
No, that's
actually. She even sprayed a perfume on it.
No, because look, yeah, if you use it, but that moment you bust, you're just gonna catch yourself in the mirror, like, yo, what did I just do, bro? I feel dirty after I jack off, so imagine if I'm fucking a little, like, just cheeks.
You go to the
fuck am I doing? What is this? Where am I?
Like, Ronnie, you're better than
this, bro. What's wrong with me?
And then you send it back.
Position.
Yes.
He's rocking. Just rocking in the rocking shower. Like, I am somebody. I can be somebody.
I said 2020 wasn't going to do this no more, man.
You got to do some good shit afterwards. You got to, like, go volunteer somewhere.
Make a donation, bro.
You see him at the soup kitchen?
Yeah, or, like, pick up trash in the highway. Hey, man, what are you in here for? You don't want to know.
You don't
want to
know.
What would you do if you got an X mold of your... X butts mold.
Oh no, I'll be a little freaked out. Like, what the fuck?
Hey, you won't sniff it though. Just
maybe, honestly.
Just to see if it's authentic.
Yeah. Yeah. Make sure it's real. Like, yeah. One time.
My question is,
it's a scratch and sniff.
Still saying.
Take a video of it, send it to her. Man, you really fell off 2020, didn't you?
What the fuck? My question is, who's gonna send one back?
Yo, actually,
you sent anyone back?
A dick print?
Yeah, a dick print.
That's just a re-gifting gift. I know,
all you gotta do is spray paint it and then send it back.
Yeah. Resend it back.
Oh, shit.
Well, I guess that does it. That does it, right? we're gonna end it.
There's no ass talk.
We're going to end it on that. All right.
End it with the mold for 2020 for the beginning. Off to a great start.
Oh, yeah.
We're only levitating from here, you know what I'm saying?
Hell yeah.
Get ready. Get ready for the mold. Get ready for the mold of Slide Through Podcast coming at you.
It's the year of the moldy ass. You already know what it is.
Hey, but don't shoot anybody over it.
Yeah.
Please don't. Please don't. And if you're going to shoot, don't shoot at the legs. What you doing?
Well, I don't know.
And,
you know what?
And don't stand by the glass door.
Yo, and, you really got scared.
And then don't be shocked in your mugshot.
But, like, I need to know what his plan was, though. Like,
I know.
He was going to go over, shoot that nigga in the legs, and then be like, all right, fix my shit. Like,
all right. Go back to his unit. This should do it.
Like, no, I didn't shoot him. What do you mean?
I had dementia.
Oh, shit, bro.
Well, yeah.
Shit, with that note.
With that note, you guys stay safe. Once again, pray for Australia, Puerto Rico, all over the world.
And the troops.
Peace in the Middle East.
Pray for yourself.
Pray for yourself. Take care of each other. Be kind to each other. Be kind to animals.
Yeah. Send an ass mold to your friends.
Mm-hmm. Our time is very limited here.
For real.
You never know who could appreciate it. You never know. So with this message... We thank you guys again for coming through.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, thanks for having us.
Thank you for having us.
We're glad you guys were able to adapt to, you know what I mean, whatever be going
it's
on
it's
in here.
It's an interesting dynamic because a lot of our friends are like you guys.
So it was easy.
Especially this guy.
Perfect fit.
We just have that one dumb friend named Dylan who just talks the same dumb shit.
That's a Dylan.
It's always a Dylan.
So it's a Dylan.
I guess I'm Dylan.
Also, salute to TM for coming through, man. Thank you.
You're
always welcome here. Thank you, Sergio, for always sliding through.
For real.
Yeah. Until next week, guys. See you later.